Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restorations. This old truck, and today we're going to turn up the heat. Well, today I'm on location at the indoor swap meet booth. Got some wares that we need to pass along to someone else. That's a good place to do it. So, this is kind of like a porcupine at the moment. It's a used heater control that we got for Whitey. So first off, we're going to strip off all the old cables. Get them out of there. I've already got it loosened up. What is this? Wiring for the light. So those come out. Where'd the other one go? Must have fallen out already. Oh, here it is. I don't happen to have a quarter inch socket with me at the moment. But they're in pretty good shape, so they come out fairly easy. There's almost no slot for that screw to put a screwdriver on. We got some new levers and a kit from Jim Carter. And instructions. There's our levers. They're held in by that pin, which needs to be driven out from that side. In order to do so, we want to support the housing on the bottom side of our socket. Try to match the diameter of the pin as best we can. Oh, but you know, before I do that, I'm going to take my buttons off. I'm missing one of these. I'm going to need one. So I want to support the housing on the backside because it's just top metal. They like to break very easily. Almost takes another pair of hands for this. Okay, we need a smaller diameter pin. Punch. See how much farther this gets us. As far as I can go with that one. I really only need to get that pin out far enough to get this lever off, and I can pull the other lever off. There it goes. Lovely. Which is still good, by the way. But we're going to get away from the die cast. And we're also going to get the chrome off of here, polish that up. Set those aside. Back to my favorite polish. This is Granitize 01 Cleaner Sealer. Or is it 02? I can't remember. And 4-0 steel wool. Getting down into these corners here is what's going to make all the difference in the world with how this thing looks. So you'll want to pay close attention to them. Okay, I'm going to want to lubricate our levers and pivots. This is like a graphite oil. Okay, that sets us up for lube. looks a little blistery peely. Let's see if I can find some. That's about just about grabber orange Chevrolet small block in it.
We'll see.
I'll probably end up replacing this switch because of all the corrosion. But when I do, those screws are readily accessible with the levers in place. So it's time to put the levers back. Short bushing, long bushing, vent lever, which is for the temperature. Oh, I guess I better put the face back on so I know which side the temperature is. This is what we're looking for. Short bushing. Where'd it go? I've lost it. This is lovely. The bushings don't fit. Great. Just great. And if I drive it on there, I won't get it back off. Maybe, just maybe. Looks like it fits. Maybe it's supposed to be an interference fit, I don't know. That's going. Ow! Ow! Sprang. A little bit different. Lever. No! It don't say piece of cake on here anywhere. I guess I should have checked that lever to make sure it went over the pin before I started this. I was assuming that it fit. Silly me. Why, it's Bird. Better. Might get that bushing on there now. Of course, now you know what I don't want to do. Just knock that out too far. Slide my lever back. Get the end of the pin put into the bushing. Oops, did not work. That's exactly what I did not want to do. So that means I now have a wasted bushing. So, this side's stretched out, this side is smashed in. So if I put my stretched out side against the pin, I could probably drive it through the smashed out end and put it back where it belongs. Takes care of that. Now it supposedly is in that bushing, the pin. This little thin aluminum bushing stuff is just garbage, because the bushing wanted to go inside the hole, which means you can't get it to stay on the pin. I'm going to try to offset it from the hole and get the pin driven most of the way through it. Now the pin's against the housing. Okay, we're through. Pin fully seated. Apparently this is supposed to fit through here. Fits through that one, I guess. So our levers line up, so the cable comes through on the inside of that lever. And it looks like the outside of this lever, so they both go through that way. Be bearing. Okay, that does it for our cable control connections. That's as good as it gets. I have to buy a whole button kit in order to get the one for this side. Unless I find one at a swap meet somewhere, which I hope to, or off another truck, maybe I'll get one of them. Ready for installation. That does it for this episode. Here's our 56 GMC heater control ready to go. If you got one you need rebuilt, you can send it to me. I'll rebuild it for you. Maybe even put it on an episode. But all said and done, we'll have to show you how we put it in. So for Redneck Restorations, this old truck, I'm Jeff Bradshaw. Well, today I'm on location at our indoor swap meet booth. Got a bunch of junk that I kind of wanted to unload. That's a good place to do it. Okay, dude. Well, today I'm on location at the indoor swap meet booth. Got some wares that we need to pass along to someone else. That's a good place to do it. Well, that pretty much does it for this episode. If you got a heater control, need it rebuilt, you can send it to me. I'll do it. Anyway, Redneck Restorations, this old truck, out there fresh. Like a rocket.
I have that in my bike repair tool kit for brake levers and shifters and derailleurs. Don't want to use it on chain, but all the other lube points.
So that does it for the take four.
I didn't have grease. I went and looked. I must have taken it out.
I got tired of waiting on you. Mark let me borrow his oil in there.
Just so you know, I'm out of acetylene too.
I use propane. Well, that does it for this episode. Take five. And there we have it.
I'm sure glad I'm not the only one that talks to myself.
Yeah, I'm talking to the camera.
Oh, are you?
Oh.
Then I'll shut up.
Being recorded. Oh, yeah, this is lovely. The bushings don't fit. So that's it for the 56 GMC heater control rebuild. Oh. If you got one you need it rebuilt, send it to me. I'll rebuild
GMC,
it for you.
You got her, huh?
Yeah, except for now I have to do it over again because you're.
Because I'm talking. Oh, I'm sorry. You're talking.
That's
to
why I said give me. That's see, why I said to give me a minute so I could do my program close.
I'll just move away.
Well, you don't have to move away. Just give me about 30 seconds. Silence!